Hello, good morning. So today we are going to see data cleaning, which is nothing but a task in data pre-processing. So it's a data pre-processing task. Okay. So we are in the subject of data mining and warehousing, and in unit one, that is introduction to data mining. Okay. So today we will see data cleaning in detail. Okay. So what are the subtasks in data cleaning? So data cleaning is itself a major task from data pre-processing, which is necessary before actually running a data mining algorithm. So out of which we are going to see data cleaning today. Okay, so let us move ahead. So these are the broad steps in data mining, just to introduce you with. So we do data cleaning, data selection, data integration, data transformation, and then after these four steps of data pre-processing, we go for data mining. Okay, so after data mining, we get some pattern, so we have to evaluate those patterns, and then we get some knowledge, we discover some knowledge out of it, and after discovering that knowledge, we find some way to represent that knowledge. Okay, so knowledge presentation. So here in the figure, you can see there is a data, then there is a selection of the data, then data pre-processing, which includes cleaning, integration, reduction, transformation, and then there is a data mining, patterns, evaluation, and then knowledge representation or knowledge presentation. After this, today we are going to see data cleaning techniques. So let us focus upon only data cleaning today. So let us see what is data cleaning, okay, or what are the major tasks in data cleaning. Okay, so we have seen that there are many sources of data, and we collect that data from various sources. So there is a data in the real world, and that is most of the time dirty. So why the data is dirty, that we will see first, why data is dirty. Okay, so there are lots of problems with the data. So the data can be incorrect data, it can be a noisy data, it can be incomplete data, it can be inconsistent data. Okay, so why the data is incomplete, why the data is incorrect, why the data is noisy, why the data is inconsistent? So there are many reasons. Okay, so we will see those reasons also. So there can be the instruments through which we enter the data, those instruments can be faulty. The person who is entering the data, maybe there is an error when he enters the data. Okay, so that is a human error, okay, or a computer error. Then while transmission of the data, if the data is corrupted, okay, so that is a transmission error. Okay, so these are the some examples that instrument can be faulty, human or computer error can be there. There may be some transmission problem. Okay, so initially we will see what is incomplete. Okay, so incomplete means what? We are lacking some values. Okay, so like consider there are some attributes or columns. Consider there is a data, and that data is available in the form of table. Okay, so table is having what? Rows and columns. So rows are referred as tuples in case of database terminology, and we are also call them as entities, right? So like consider customer is an entity. So for one customer there is one row or one tuple. Okay, so there are rows and there are columns. So columns are what? These are also called as attributes or features. So columns are also called as attributes or features of the data, right? So they can be like customer ID, customer name, customer age, customer's address, customer email, etc. So those are attributes. So lacking attribute values, if we are lacking some attribute values, that is called as incomplete data. If we are lacking certain attributes of interest, like there are 10 columns or 10 attributes, and out of which we are interested in 4 columns or 4 attributes, and there in those attributes also there are some missing values. So what we say, lacking certain attributes of interest or containing only aggregate data, that means what? Tell data, like suppose in the address column, in the address column or in the address attribute, we are expecting what? A detailed address, like what is the house number, what is the street, okay? Then what is the area, what is the city, what is the state, and then what is the country, right? So suppose somebody have only entered a state or city. So somebody entered only city. So that is what? An aggregate data. We don't know the details, right? Somebody may enter just a state or country, okay? So that is an aggregate data. So it is difficult to find the details out of it. So that data is called as incomplete data. So this is the first problem with the data, which we have to deal with in data cleaning. Second is data can be noisy. Now what is noisy? It can contain what? Noise. Now what is noise? It is not the noise which we see or which we hear, okay, on the roads, okay, so while traveling. Okay, so this noise is about the noise in the data. So that noisy data means what? It's a data with some errors, okay, errors or outliers. For example, suppose there is a salary attribute or salary column, and in that salary attribute or a salary column, we have a value in negative. Okay, so negative values are there. So is it possible to have a negative value for salary? No, it is not possible, right? Because if there is a negative value for salary, that means employee is not taking the salary, he is giving back the salary to the management or the organization, right? So that is not the case. Salary is always positive, right? It should be a positive value. So if there is a negative value, that is what? Error. Okay, consider there is an attribute for mobile number, and the value is consist of only 5 digits. Okay, actually it should consist what? 10 digits, but the mobile number, some values of the mobile numbers are only 5 digits, 6 digits. So that is called as errors, okay, or outliers. So that is called as a noisy data when the data consists of errors or outliers. After that, data can be inconsistent. Data can be inconsistent. So like we have to deal with incomplete and noisy data, we should or we need to deal with inconsistent data also in case of data cleaning. So what is an inconsistent data? The data containing discrepancies. So which are the discrepancies? Like previously, suppose there is a university or a college which is using some rating, okay, which is using some rating. Previously they are using percentages to declare the result, and now they are using what? Grades or credits to declare the results, okay? So the previous database which they have, and now they are having what? CGPA or SGPA in the result column. Similarly, there will be discrepancies between the ratings. Like suppose previously somebody is using rating for rankings, like 1, 2, 3, and now they are using a rating for ranking as ABC. Okay, so this is what the discrepancy is. So previously the database which is created would be having 1, 2, 3 in the ranks, and now there is ABC. Okay, so this is an inconsistent data which we have to deal with in case of data cleaning. Okay, so we have to understand this, and we have to clean this data also. We have to make it in a single and uniform format. Okay, it should be either 1, 2, 3 or it should be ABC. Okay, salary should not be a negative value, it must be a positive value. And if we are missing some values, for example, occupation is a attribute, and for some rows or for some customer, occupation value is missing. So we have to deal with that missing value. Okay, one more is intentionally. Sometimes intentionally, the data is disused, and that is missing data is there. Okay, so in that case, we have a noisy data, that is an erroneous or wrong data. So that is when, consider an example of there are some peoples, like they don't know their birthdays. Okay, they don't know their birthdays. Okay, the people, generally old peoples, okay, of the current generation, sometimes they don't Now they want to issue Aadhaar cards. So in that case, government have decided to give them such people's a birth date, a common birth date, and that is 1 January. Okay, January 1. Okay, so that is intentionally a wrong data is created, and that is to resolve some problems. Okay, that is to get out of some problems. Okay, because in Aadhaar card there must be some birth date, right? Or in some document there must be a birth date. Okay, so these are the reasons, and that is why the data is what? Dirty. Why the data is dirty? Because it is incomplete, because it is noisy, because it is inconsistent, and intentionally sometimes we create the error in the data, right? So this dirty data is there, and that is why we need to clean the data. So we have seen why the data is dirty, okay, and what are the reasons behind creating a dirty data. Okay, so dirty data is because it is incomplete, it is noisy, right? It is inconsistent, right? So we have seen what is the need of cleaning the data. Okay, because we have to fill in the missing values, right? So we have to deal with missing values, we have to deal with noisy data, we have to consider data cleaning as a process. Okay, so let us see further. So this is the data which is incomplete, noisy, and inconsistent, and now we will see how we can deal with the problems of incomplete, noisy, and inconsistent data. Okay, so what are the solutions to deal with this dirty data? Initially, for missing values, what will be the solution? We have to fill in missing values. We have to fill in missing values. After that, we have to smooth out. If there is a noise, there is an error. Okay, suppose a mobile number is only 8 digits, so it should be 10, right? If the height value, if the height value is 15 feet for a customer, so is it possible to have a height of 15 feet? No, it is not possible, right? Maximum height is 6 or 7 feet, right? So this is a noise or error, right? So we have to smooth out this noise. After that, there is some error or outliers, so we have to identify and remove those outliers. If there is some inconsistency, like some values of the result attribute are in percentages and some are in credits like SGPA or CGPA, so all the values should be either in percentages or in the credits, right? If there is a weight column, okay, so some values are in kilograms and some values are in some other, like some other metric. Okay, so we have to bring all the values in a same metric. Okay, for a height column, height attribute, if some values are in centimeter and some values are in feet, so that will generate or that will create inconsistency. So we have to bring them either in centimeter, all values will be in centimeter, or in feet, right? So this is how. Then we will see how we can deal with these things. Okay, so we know that we have to fill the missing values, we have to smooth out the noise, we have to identify and remove outliers. So let us see how we can deal with this. So first we will deal with initially missing values. Okay, so how we can deal with missing values? Okay, so initially there are some methods. Okay, there are various solutions, there are multiple solutions. Okay, so in attribute a value is missing, in an attribute a value is missing, so maybe like in attribute there are thousands of values, so thousand of values refers to or belongs to thousands of rows, right? So consider there is a table of 1000 rows, okay, and 10 columns, 1000 rows and 10 columns. So there is a column in which 4 to 5 values are missing, 4 to 5 values are missing. So in 1000 only 4 to 5 values are missing, right? So one solution to that is we can ignore that, right? Consider there is a row. Okay, like for a row there are 10 columns, right? For a customer record there are 10 columns, and out of that 10 columns, if seven values are missing. So out of 10 values in the record of a customer, 7 values are missing or 6 values are missing. So several values are missing. So we can ignore such rows. We just delete those rows from our database, and that is called as first method of dealing with the missing values, and that is called as ignore the tuples. Ignore those rows where the number of missing values are many. Okay, so it is not possible to bring all those values. Okay, we cannot find out all those values, right? If the single value or two values are missing, then it is okay, right? So if several missing values are there, then just ignore such rows or tuples or records, okay, from the database. So ignore means what? Just delete them. Okay, so that is the solution to deal with missing value. Now second is what? We can fill the missing value manually. We can fill the missing values manually. So how we can fill manually? Suppose we know the source of the data. Okay, the data from which the source from which we have brought our data, right? So using that source, we can find out what are the values, correct values for the missing locations, right? The locations where the missing values are there, we can find out the correct values from the source, and we can enter them manually. Yes, but that is what, this is the solution, but that solution will be a time consuming solution, because if the number of missing values are many, so finding out their correct values maybe from the source of the database, or maybe the organization who have provided that database, so asking them, entering the values manually will be a time consuming process. Third method is there, that is using a global constant. So instead of asking anybody, instead of deleting the tuples or ignoring the tuples, just decide a global constant and just insert that global constant. Okay, so suppose that global constant will be like, if it's an integer value, enter 999. If it's a string, enter NA, not available, or unknown, or infinity. Okay, so this is also a method which is used to deal with missing values. After this, there is a better method out of these, like ignoring, filling manually, using global constant. Out of these three, now these are better solutions, like central tendency of attribute, but this is possible for only the columns or attributes which consist of integer values, integer or numeric values, right? So for such columns or attributes, we can use what? We can find their mean or median. Okay, like suppose for height, so height is in suppose it is mentioned in centimeter, okay, in a particular column, and for some customers the height is missing. For some customers or for some students, if it's a student database, the height is missing. So what we will do, we will find the mean of all the available values of the height. Mean, right? Mean means average, right? We will find the mean, and then we will replace that missing value by that average value. Okay, so that is what mean. Similarly, we can find out median. Okay, so if there are like some number of values, find out the median value and replace the missing value by that median value. Okay, so this is also possible. Suppose I can give you an example. We receive the electricity bills at home, right? We receive electricity bills at home. So if in some month we fail to submit the reading, or the person who collects the reading, he fails to submit the reading to the office, right, electricity office, so what happens, they send us a message that we did not receive your reading, the electricity meter reading for this month. So we are generating the bill as per what? As per the average or mean of previous months, right? So they consider previous 3 to 4 months and find out the mean value, okay, of the reading, and then generate the bill according to that mean, right? Mean or median. So this is an example which we can use to replace what? Missing value, right? So it was a missing value in the electricity office for some customer. So how they deal with it? How they find out the solution? They consider their four previous months and they find out what? The mean of those 4 months readings, and they consider that mean for the current month to generate the electricity bill, right? So this is how we can deal with missing values. One more solution is there, which is again a better solution for dealing with the missing values, and that is what? Using the most probable value. Using the most probable value. So this is possible by some algorithms, which can be used to generate the probable values. So like decision tree. Decision tree is an algorithm which is used to predict the missing values. Okay, so we can use such algorithms to predict the probable values, and we can use that probable value to replace a missing value. Okay, so I hope you have understood. I hope you have understood this. So this is how we can deal with missing values. So ignore the tuple, fill missing value manually. Then you can use global constant. You can use central tendency of attribute. You can find out the mean, like mean or median, to replace the missing value. Or you can use a decision tree. Okay. So after this, this was about missing values. Now we will see how to deal with noisy data. Okay. How to deal with noisy data. So noise is what we have seen. What is a noise? It's a random error. Okay. So it may happen because of a faulty instrument or a human error or a computer error or a transmission error, right? So this is a random error or a variance. Variance means what? It's a deviation from an expected value. It's a deviation from expected value. Now what is the expected value? Suppose for mobile number, what is the expected number of digits? 10 digits are expected. Okay, so if they are 9 or 8, so this is what? Deviation from an expected value. Okay, for a height, from like suppose like 3 feet for a adult customer, if it's a customer database or if it's a student database, right? So the expected height is what? From like 3 feet or 3 feet to 7 feet, right? So if it is in 10 or more than 10 feet, so that is what? Deviation from an expected value, right? So such outliers represents noise. Such outliers represent noise. Here an example that there is an attribute, okay? There is a table of database, right? In the database, there is a table having number of rows and some columns. So that column is what? Also referred as attribute or feature. So there is an attribute price. There is an attribute price. And this price attribute is having what? Noise. This attribute price is having some noise. So what is the noise that we have seen? So it's a deviation from expected value. So how we can bring a correct value? How we can bring correct or a value which is close to the correct value? Okay, so this is a solution or this is the method to deal with noisy data. So binning is a technique, regression is a technique, and outlier analysis is a technique. So what is a binning? So this binning is also called as bucket or bins. Okay, so we use buckets or bins in binning. So here first method in binning is what? Use a neighborhood value. So they are considering that in the bucket or in the bin, there are number of values. In the bucket or bin, there are number of values. Okay, so suppose for in the database or in the table, in a particular column, in a particular column, a value is missing. One or two values are missing. So what we will do, we will replace that missing value by the neighborhood value. So we will just copy neighborhood value, okay, the value which is next to it, okay, we just copy that value at the place of missing value. Okay, so that is what using a neighborhood value. So that is local smoothing. Okay, then smoothing by bean means, second method is what of binning is smoothing by bean means. So mean is what? Consider in the bucket there are three values, 4, 8 and 15. In the bucket there are three values, 4, 8 and 15, right? So we will find out the mean of this. So what is the total of 4, 8 and 15? 15 plus 8 and then 4. So it's 27. So 27 by 3, so that is 9. So replace all the values in the bean by the mean. So instead of 4, 8, 15, we will use what? 9, 9, and 9. So this is what smoothing by bean means. Okay, second is what, we know that there is a noise, right? So we will smooth out this noise by bean means. Now one more is what, bean medians. So what is bean median? These are the values in the bucket. For example, we are considering only three values to understand. Actually, if we consider, there are thousands of values in the bucket. Okay, so that happens automatically when we apply the logic or we apply the formula, right? So we are considering here only three values, like 4, 8 and 15. So what is the median value? 8, right? So replace 4, 8 and 15 by 8, median value. So we are smoothing out the noise by bin median. So it is 8, 8 and 8, okay? Now smoothing by bean boundaries. Now there are two boundaries, okay, smoothing the noise by bean boundaries. Now there are two boundaries, 4 and 15. Now 4 is a lower boundary and 15 is a higher boundary. Okay, so if we suppose in a database, for a particular attribute we are applying this binning, and in that attribute there are thousands of values. Okay, so initially when we apply binning, we have to sort all the values. We have to sort all the values in the increasing order. In the increasing order, if we want to smooth out the noise by bin boundaries. Why? Because we need to find out the lower value and the upper value. Okay, so here 4, 8 and 15. 4 is the lower boundary, 15 is the upper boundary. So as 4 is close to the lower boundary, that is 4, so it remains 4. Now 8. 8 is close to what, 15 or 4? Difference between 8 and 4 is 4, and difference between 8 and 15 is 7. So 8 is more close to the 4, so it remains what, as it is, and that is what, to the lower boundary, that is 4. Okay, so here initially there is 4, then actually this 8 will become what, 4, because as it is close to the lower boundary, so it will be replaced by lower boundary, and that is 4. And this 15 is close to the higher, so it remains 15. Okay, so 8 will be converted into 4. Okay, there is a problem here in the slide. I need to change this. So 8 becomes what? 4, as it is close to the lower boundary. So this is the method which is used for smoothing by bean boundaries. Okay, so binning techniques are used to smooth out the noise, and we can do this by replacing a noisy value by a neighborhood value, or by bean means, by bean median, or bean boundaries. Okay, after that, regression is there. We know that there are two types of regression, that is a linear and a multiple linear regression. So this method is also used to find out the value which is close to the correct values. Okay, so we draw a line between the correct values, which is as close as to the correct values. Okay, so this is one, this is second actually method, second solution to find out or smooth out the noise, regression. And third is outlier analysis. So we use clustering for this to find out the outliers Okay, so in clustering, we know we just accept the number of values of the attributes, then we form the clusters, and the values which are not there in the clusters, okay, so they are identified as outliers, and so we identify them as outliers and we just remove them, okay, or we delete those values, okay, so just find the odd ones and just remove them. So that is what outliers analysis. So these are the methods to deal with noisy data. Initially, we know what is noise. It's a random error or a variance, and we can deal with this variance. We just want to bring that a deviated value, a variance or an error value to its correct or the value which is close to the correct value. So we can do this by binning, regression, or outlier analysis. So I hope you have understood what is a noisy data and how we can deal with this noisy data. So after this, as we want to see that data cleaning is nothing but a process, right? It also consists of many steps, like initially we have to deal with the missing values, then we have to deal with the noisy data, okay, and then we have to deal with the inconsistent data, okay. So data cleaning is also referred as a process, like data mining is a process. Why? Because it is not completed in a single step. It takes multiple steps, right? So similarly, data cleaning is also a process. So here, there are discrepancies. Okay, so discrepancy means what we have seen, like in a result column, sometimes previously they were using percentages, okay, and now they are using credits or grades. Okay, in a height column, previously they were using centimeters and now they are using feet or meter. Okay, so that is a discrepancy, right? So how to detect such discrepancies? So these discrepancies are caused by many reasons. Okay, so what are the reasons behind these discrepancies? So the reason may be a poorly designed data form entries. A poorly designed data entry forms, right? Suppose there is a form which is designed for a data entry, and that form consists of a field for entering the height, to enter the height. Okay, suppose that form is for student, and that is for sports. Okay, so there is a form for entry in the sports, and there is a field height, as well as there is a field result, previous year result. Okay, so they have not mentioned that in bracket that what is in which metric we should enter the height, right? In centimeter or in meter or in feet. So what will happen? Some students may enter it in centimeters, some may enter in feet, some may enter it in meter, right? Now in case of previous year result, some may enter it in percentages, some may enter it in SGPA or CGPA, some may enter it in like a class, first class, second class, distinction. Okay, so the forms which are used for data entry must be designed properly. If they are mentioning to enter something, they should mention what are the possible values or what is the possible metric somebody may consider, right? So in bracket for height, they can mention enter height in centimeter, enter height in feet, or enter the result in percentages, or enter the result in grades like SGPA or CGPA, etc., right? Now second reason behind inconsistencies is human error that we have seen in data entry. Human may enter a value which is not correct. Somebody purposefully entering the wrong data. Okay, so consider you visited a showroom just to enjoy, like looking the or just viewing the bikes or cars, but you don't want to give your mobile number. But when you about to leave from that showroom, they ask about your mobile number, okay, just for inquiry. So sometimes we purposefully write a wrong mobile number, okay, so that is purposefully entered a wrong data, right? So data decay, that is outdated data, right? So suppose we have the data of the customers, okay, and in the address column we have an address where customer do not stay currently, right? So it's not a current address, it's an outdated address. So that is also a problem. So it's outdated address means it's the wrong data, right? So that is a reason. Next is error in instrumentation devices. So if there is error in that means the devices are faulty, or inconsistencies due to data integration. So when we integrate the data together, which we will see in the next lecture, the problem of the inconsistency caused by data integration. Okay, so these are the reasons behind data inconsistencies or discrepancies, and this is how we can resolve them. So how we can resolve the data discrepancies? We can use the metadata. We can use what? Metadata. Metadata means what? We can use mean or median or mode, okay, of the data, okay, and we can resolve that. Okay, so like suppose some value is a wrong value. Okay, so what we find out? Mean of the other values, and we can replace that wrong value by mean, right? So that is metadata. We can use a unique rule. What is a unique rule? If some value is wrong or missing, just write a unique value in, at that place. Then we can use a consecutive rule. Now, what is a consecutive rule? Suppose there is a checkbook, right? And there are 10 checks, okay? 10 leaves are there, okay, of checks. So suppose you have maintained the record of, or suppose bank have maintained the record of 9 checks, and they are missing one check number. They are missing one check number. So how we can, how they can resolve this problem? They can find out, because check numbers are in sequence, in a consecutive sequence, right? Like 01. So from 202001 to 202010. So they are in 01 to 10. Right, last two digits are 01 to 10. So if one check number is missing in the bank database for a particular customer, what they can do, which solution they will use? Consecutive rule. Okay, so they will see from 01 to 10, which number is missing. Maybe like 7 is missing, so that the number we are missing is what? Nothing but 07, right? So this is a solution called as consecutive rule. Then a null rule. What is a null rule? That is not applicable. We are missing some value, just write NA. Data scrubbing tools. So what is data scrubbing tools? Such as postal addresses, spell checking, etc. Okay, so suppose there is a string in a particular attribute. There are strings, right, entered. Like for, suppose there is a column for result or class obtained in a final year result. So people are entering like first class, second class, third class, okay, or pass class, right? So if there is a spelling mistake, like instead of FIRST, they have entered FIST, okay? So using spell check data scrubbing tool, we can get a recommendation that this may be FIRST first, okay? So we can or a data manager can use data scrubbing tools to understand this, okay, data discrepancies. Then we can also use data auditing tools to find variations or outliers. Variations or outliers. For example, in the height attribute, if the height is mentioned in feet, and we have a value of 15 feet or 20 feet. So that is what? An outlier. Okay. So there are some data auditing tools which will directly find out such outliers, and they will suggest you to whether to keep them or remove them from the data, right? So similarly, there are some data migration tools, okay, such as data migration tools like, suppose there are two columns, sex and gender. There are two columns, sex and gender. So sex column is in one database and gender column is in another database. And we want to merge these two databases together. So actually sex and gender column are same, right? Sex and gender column are same. They mention the same data, like male or female or transgender, right? So their values are same. They actually represent a same attribute, column or feature, right? So what we can do? A data migration tool will understand this, that sex and gender are the same columns. So a sex column from one database and a gender column from another database, they will consider single column, okay, while integrating or merging these two databases together. Okay, so they are called as data migration tools. Now there are ETL tools, extraction, transformation and loading. That is, extract the data, okay, then transform it and then load it in a database, okay, in a target database. Okay, so suppose we are collecting the database from many sources. So we are extracting the data from different sources, right? Now that data need to be transformed, okay, so that it should be converted into a suitable form, okay, which is necessary for the target database, right? So that is transformation. And after doing this transformation, when data becomes suitable to load in the next target database, which is collected from various other sources, then we load that data into the target database. For example, data warehouse. Okay, so these are the techniques. So we have seen what are the reasons behind inconsistencies or discrepancies, and what are the solutions we can apply. Okay, so reasons can be poorly designed data forms, human error, purposefully entered wrong data, data gets outdated, errors, okay, instrumentation faulty. And resolutions, maybe we can use metadata, unique rule, consecutive rule, null rule, ETL tools, okay, to deal with this discrepancy or inconsistency of the data. So this is how we come to the end. So we have seen how the data is dirty, because data is what? Incomplete, inconsistent and noisy, right? It consists of inaccurate values, it consists of noisy values, it consists of inconsistent values, right? So we have to deal with all these things. So we have seen what are the reasons and what are the solutions, how we can deal with missing values. We have seen the methods, how we can deal with noisy data. Okay, there are various methods like binning, regression, right? And outlier analysis, clustering, right? And after that, we have also seen what is the discrepancy, okay? How it comes, how inconsistencies arises, and how we can deal with those inconsistencies or discrepancies. Okay, I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. If you have any doubt, you can ask.